नमस्कार, इट इज़ माय प्लेजर एंड प्रिविलेज टू अटेंड द ऑनलाइन वर्कशॉप बाय टीचिंग लर्निंग सेंटर एंड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिकल एजुकेशन एंड स्पोर्ट्स साइंसेज, रामानुजन कॉलेज, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ दिल्ली, रिविटलाइजिंग द लाइफ स्टाइल थ्रू योगा प्रैक्टिसेस. टुडे माय टॉपिक इज मर्मा थेरेपी. नाउ जस्ट we have to know the relationship between the yoga and the marma science. Marma therapy is the oldest Vedic medical science, and marma science and yoga are two sides of a coin. We can understand the interrelationship of marma science and the yoga. Whenever we are doing any yogic posture or the yogic practice, ultimately we are going to stimulate some specific body marma points. So we can say that the yogic postures are affecting the human body through marma points. First of all, just we have to understand the, before giving my lecture on the marma science and marma therapy, I want to show some cases successfully treated with the marma science. It is very effective therapy even in those cases where the surgery is not complete answer. Just I am giving some presentation, and before going to give this presentation, I want to show some cases which are very effective in by the marma science and marma therapy. Just we can say that the marma science and marma therapy is the need of the hour, and few cases successfully treated by marma therapy are, first of all, the keloid. Second one is the non-union of the fracture, and third one is the autosomal recessive congenital ichthyosis. These all three groups are not easily treated by the conventional medical sciences. Just you can see the post-burn contractures and the keloid in this condition. When the burn takes place in the body, ultimately there are a lot of contractures in the body, and a lot of complications are also there. In this condition, you can see the patient cannot move the neck because there is keloid in the neck region. Simultaneously, the keloid is all over the body, and you can see the skin graft was done, and the skin was taken from the thigh. Full thickness, thickness graft was taken from the thigh, and the plastic surgery was done. Even in the donor side, as you can see, the keloid formation. So a lot of symptoms like itching, irritations, redness, and inflammatory process takes place in the different part of the body. The second case of the burn, as you can see, the efficacy of marma science and marma therapy in the case of the keloid. Just you can appreciate these slides, and you can see the response of the marma therapy. Ultimately, just you can see, there is complete cure of this keloid is there. At last, you cannot even see the previous lesion over the hand. Second one, in the non-union of the fracture of the humerus, even in this case, after the operative process, after the onlay graft, there was non-union in the shaft of the humerus, and after giving the marma therapy, you can see there was complete union of the fracture was there within 1.5 months. You can appreciate these slides, and you can see the third case of the ichthyosis, and there is a remarkable response within 2 or 3 months. Yes, you can see. Now, first of all, just we will understand the definition of the marma. What are the marma? According to the medical definition, the specific point of the body, parts of the body which are very vulnerable to trauma known as marma. Any trauma to these places may lead to death or many other complications regarding the physio-anatomical functions and anatomical configuration. As we know that during surgical intervention, we have to save some body points because any surgical procedure or the parasurgical procedure may lead to damage these points. So we have to very much careful for these points. Just we can say that there is a example of the battle of the Lord Rama and the Ravana. And the demise of the Lord Krishna is very important because the arrow was pierced in the foot, and this place is known as the Tal Hriday Marg. In same way, the Jesus Christ was crucified and the nailing was done over four marma points, and they are known as the Tal Hriday Marg, and the demise of the Jesus Christ was taken place. Now, just you can see, when there is injury to the Tal Hriday Marg, a lot of important anatomical structures are damaged. So injury to the Manibandh Marg is also very important. Just you can say, see that if there is injury to the Manibandh or the wrist joint, a lot of nerves, ligaments, blood vessels, bones, and the joint is injured, are injured. The Shravan Kumar and the demise due to the arrow injury on the Sthapani Marg, it is very important example because the arrow thrown by Raja Dasarath was at the junction of the eyes, and it is very important marma point, and the demise of Shravan Kumar was there. In recent era, just you can see the example of the Philip Hughes. Philip Hughes was died at the age of 25 years after Australian batsman was struck in the head by a bouncer at the Sydney cricket ground. So you can say that these marma points are very effective, and when they are injured, a lot of complications or the death may occur. So it is very important, and in Ayurveda, the definition is the Maryantiti Marmani. Means if it is injured and it is pierced, the death may occur. And second example was of Raman Lamba, the Indian cricket player. He was also died by severe head injury after being hit on head by the cricket ball. So we can say that we know that in many accidental cases, some people die without massive outside injuries. But some people get extensive outside injuries, they become healthy after the proper treatment. It means when the injury takes place over these marma points, it is very fatal, or remaining part of the body which does not contains a specific marma point, if it is injured, the patient may survive. So it means when the vital points are injured, person dies, and these vital points are important for the survival of the human being. So just we can understand the importance of these marma points. And marma science and the marma therapy is the oldest way of healing in the world. It is known as the important Vedic medical science. As we know that the Ayurveda, 5 to 10 thousand years, and Chinese medical system is also 5 to 10 thousand years old. Arabian medical system is 1400 year old, and modern medical science is about 300 years. Homeopathy is 150 years, and many other folk medical sciences were present in the different part of the globe time to time, but they are not in existence today. So we can say that the marma science and marma therapy is universally sustainable medical system and in existence since the evolution of human being on earth. It is the oldest way, because before the evolution of the yoga, before the evolution of the Ayurveda, there was simple, the marma science was there, and because it was inherent medical system, inherent power of the healing in the human body, one can treat any ailment with the help of these marma points. The marma science has already benefited thousands of patients with amazing results in different incurable diseases. It is non-surgical, non-medicinal, interventional intervention, reaching the poorest strata and curing all kind of neurological, bone, and other ailments. A number of common diseases like hypertension, diabetes, painful knee disease can also be easily treated by marma therapy, because we know that a lot of diseases occurs due to the just you can say the lifestyle disorders. A lifestyle disorders are due to the our daily life style. When we are working on the computer, we are working on the different occupations, a lot of complications may be there, a lot of diseases may be there, a lot of symptoms may be there. For all these symptoms, just we can use these marma points to cure these diseases. Now, what is the present global scenario of the health system? The 20th century witnessed the rise of an unprecedented global health divide. Industrial or the high income countries experienced the rapid improvement in standards of the living, nutrition, health and the healthcare. We can say that our country and underdeveloped nations are facing not only with a complex mixture of diseases and a number of illness promoting conditions. In that condition, just we have to make a very good infrastructure, medical infrastructure. But with the help of this medical science, especially the marma science, just we can do a lot of things and we can give relief to all the people without extra expense or extra budget. The universal access of the good quality of health care. Considering the following headings, in mandatory to assess the good quality health care is sufficient nutritive food, the water, sanitation, and the good health education. These are the four very important topics which we have to consider for the providing the good quality health in our country or the worldwide. Just in the declaration of the Alma Ata, just we can say that the declaration of Alma Ata in 1978, a vision of justice in health, regardless of the income, gender, ethnicity or education, and called for health for all by the year 2000 through primary health care. But it was not achieved till 2020. So we can say while much progress has been made since the declaration at the end of the first decade of the 21st century, much remains to be done to achieve the global health equity. Just we can say that economic recession tempered enthusiasm for primary health care and momentum shifted to programs concentrating on a few priority measures such as immunization, oral rehydration, breastfeeding, growth monitoring for the child survival, and some topics, or just you can say the concentration of the priority was also changed after the corona COVID infection. Just we can say there is a failure of the medical health system because health services have failed to make their contribution to reduce these pervasive social inequalities by ensuring universal access to existing scientifically validated low-cost interventions such as insecticide-treated bed nets for the malaria. Just we have to increase the taxes on the cigarette. Short courses chemotherapy, just we have to give antibiotic treatment for the pneumonia is very important. Dietary modifications and secondary prevention measures for high blood pressure and the high cholesterol level is very necessary. And the water treatment and oral rehydration therapy for the diarrhea is very important nowadays. Just we can say that Indian Vedic medical system having the people reflects the society, social welfare parameters of any civilized state, and this was the valuable achievement of the ancient Indian society. The marma science and the marma therapy is the instant way of the healing. Just you can say that just we are giving response within a couple of minutes. It is the permanent way of healing. It is the natural way of healing, and it is non-invasive way of healing, because in this condition just we are not giving any surgical intervention and we don't need any medicine for treating the diseases with the marma science and marma therapy. Marma science is the oldest and easily available. It is free, it is universally sustainable and self-dependent and often instant result-oriented way of healing or the treatment. It is non-invasive and can be applied without surgical intervention and medication. In this condition, you have not to do any surgical intervention and there is no need of the active medication. This time, we can say that the real solution for the health problem is the marma therapy. There is historical background of the Marma therapy from where we got the basis of this Marma science and Marma therapy, because it is originated from the Anganyas and the Karanyas. During the all rituals, we used to do the Anganyas and the Karanyas, important part of the all rituals. This you can say, see that during all these Yajna, Havan or the spiritual activities, just we are applying some paste, some sandalwood paste, some water, or just we are touching some specific point of the body. And you can see the Yajnopavit Sanskar, same procedure is there. And Sankhadvani, when we are doing any ritual, we are doing the Sankhadvani. And during this process, just we are stimulating the Marma point of the neck, because when we are blowing the conch, ultimately there is pressure over these Marma points which are located in the neck region. It was the key component of the social values and indication of the concern shown for the welfare of the common man by the Indian society, because it was the integral part of the all rituals in every day. Just we have to perform all these things in three times. It is known as the Trikal Sandhya. Anganyas and the Karanyas was the integral part of these rituals. In the thousands of years of the history of the India, from Vedas to the present times, Indian society has proved that only the Vedic system, medical system, can develop and provide a truly humane and efficient health service to our nation. We have inherited a very old, in fact the oldest Vedic medical system in our country, and it is known as the Ayurveda. World history does not show such a viable and existing medical system like India's anywhere else across the globe, because it is the oldest system in the world, and it is now it is also very popular nowadays. After the corona, just a lot of people, a maximum people, are using the Ayurvedic medicines, and they are very much keen to know the advantage of this Ayurvedic science. Therefore, the further development and the expansion of such a viable medical system is the need of the hour. The Vedic medical system, in terms of the Marma science, is highly humane. It is free, it is easily available and widely accessible in all aspects for all. We can deal a lot of complications, a lot of diseases in mass, and we can give relief to all these people without more expense. We have to make plan to fight against diseases with Marma science, yoga, along with the herbal medicines. And in this aspect, every person has the right to health protection by himself through Marma science and Marma therapy. Just you can see, the Marma therapy is the universally sustainable medical system, because it is universally, the Marma points are universally present in all the human beings, and they are equally distributed all over the body. Marma science and Marma therapy also guarantees the elderly and disabled to improve the quality of life as well as rehabilitation, in comparison to the present situation where involving the medical science. In modern medical science, where the billions of dollars are invested in diagnostic tools, laboratory techniques, infrastructure, but the net gain in terms of the treatment is very limited. As we know that even in this hypertension, in diabetes, in hyperacidity, in any other disease, just we have to take the medicine for a longer period, or for a lifelong, just we have to take the medicine. But we cannot treat the root cause of the disease, just we are managing the symptoms accordingly. Instrument-dependent medical science, as you can see, that just we are making the diagnosis through the these instruments, and just we are treating the cases with the these instruments. The self-dependent power of healing, in reference to the health solutions, the power of self-healing is inherent in the human body in terms of 107 Marmasthan, and they are known as the vital points, and they are in existence in all human beings. The nature has provided all things to us which are necessary for our existence, and also provided many powers for mortal and immortal gains. The power of self-healing is one of them, by which we can keep ourselves fit physically, mentally, and spiritually. Before understanding the Marma science, we have to consider the existence of the natural power of self-healing in human being. Because there is a, just you can see the Buddhist tradition, it is just like the blowing of the conch, jisko hum log kehte hain ki it is the sankha dhwani. The same tradition is in the Buddhist tradition. Just they are also blowing the bamboo pipe, and ultimately just they are stimulating the marma points of the neck. We can see there are 107 marma points in the human body, and they are distributed all over the body. Above the neck, there are 37 points which are distributed in the neck and the head region. In extremities, there are 11 points in all four extremities. The total number is 44. And the on back, there are 14 marma points, and thorax and the abdomen, there are 12 marma points are located. According to the locations, as you can see in upper extremity, lower extremity, chest, abdomen, back and the above neck, there are different marma points, and their total number of the marma point is 107. There is some effect of the trauma over these marma points. The classification of marma depends on the effect of the trauma over these marma points and what are the symptoms. The total marma points are 107. For in these marma points, 19 marma points are fatal. They are known as sadhya pranahar marma. Delayed fatals are 33 in number, and they are known as kalantar pranahar marma. Three marmas are fatal after the foreign body removal. They are vishalyagna marma, and 44 marma are disabling or the vaikalyakar marma, and 8 are painful or the rujakar marma. So just we can say that all these marma points are categorized or under this classification in five groups. Marma according to the structure, there is a definition that they are considered as the junction of the mans, sira, snayu, asthi and sandhi. Mans means the flesh, sira means the blood vessel, snayu means the ligament, asthi means the bone, and the sandhi means the joint. When the all five structures are joining, it is known as the marma point. So it is very important that all these 107 marma points are divided into the five groups according to the structure or the constituent part. There are 11 mans marmas and 41 sira marmas are there, 27 snayu marma, 8 asthi marma, and 20 sandhi marmas are there. 41 sira marmas are very effective, very important, very fatal. So just we have to consider the structural aspect of these marma points, because whenever we are giving the marma therapy, just we have to consider the constituent part of this marma point. So this category is very important. This description is very important, and just we have to keep in our mind that the every marma point consists a different type. So we have to consider this classification during the marma therapy or the marma stimulation. According to the Ayurveda, there is a system of marma is also inherent in the human body, which regulates the all body and the brain functions. By the stimulation of these points, one can treat a number of diseases. Just you can see the system of marma point. There is distribution all over the body. As just compared to the computer, just we can perform a lot of functions of the computer with the help of this keyboard. In same way, with the help of this these marma points, just we can perform or we can stimulate, we can give the stimulation to these points, and we can regulate the function of the brain as well as the function of the body. Distribution of the marma points in human body, there is 11 marma points in every extremity. There are 12 points in the thorax and abdomen. There are 14 marma points on the back. There are 37 marma points above the clavicle in the neck region and the head region. So there are total 100 marma points distributed all over the body, and these marma points are not superficial marma points, and they are not located only over the skin. They are deep physio-anatomical structures, and we are related with the different systems of the body. You can see the skeletal system, because we have to know the skeletal system, all about the skeletal system, because when we are identifying the location of the marma points, we have to consider the different bones, and in comparison to bones, just we are making the identification of this these marma points. Now, just we have to consider the types of the marma therapy. Marma therapy can be divided into three types. Number one, the self marma therapy. Second one is the curative marma therapy or the therapeutic marma therapy, and the third one is the follow-up marma therapy. So in management of the different diseases by marma points in the upper extremity, we have to show some marma points. I want to show you some marma points, because you have to see the marma points of upper extremity. First of all, we have to see the marma point located over here. It is known as the Tal Hirdaya Marma. Whenever we are making the fist, and just we are releasing all three fingers, and the middle finger touches the palm, it is the site of the Tal Hirdaya Marma. Maharshi Kashyap has discussed in Kashyap Sanhita that the human body having the five hearts in the human body, and they four Tal Hirdaya Marma are located in the palm and the sole, as well as the heart in the thorax. Just we can, these are the remote sensing techniques. By the stimulation of this Tal Hirdaya Marma, we can stimulate the function of the brain as well as the function of the heart. Because how we can consider, how we can find out the actual location, just it is the first technique to identify the actual location of the Tal Hirdaya Marma. The second technique is just we have to draw a line, a longitudinal line. And from this point to this point, it is six finger, four finger and two finger. And mid of this palm, just we are dividing a line, and there is a point over here. And just you can see, whenever we are making the fist, ultimately the tip of the middle finger is touching the same point. Just it is known as the Tal Hirdaya Marma, and it is very important to stimulate the marma point, this marma point, and we can regulate the function of, as well as the function of the brain, as well as the function of the heart. So it is very important, and it is very specific for the hypertension, for coronary artery disease, for cerebral palsy, for the brain related ailments in the human being. Now just we have to give see the another point, which is located over here. It is known as Kshipra Marma. How we are going to identify the actual location? Just we can put this crease over this web, and just you can travel this thumb over this point, and it is the space between these two carpal bones. There is a space. This is the actual location of this Kshipra Marma, and this Kshipra Marma is over here, and it is very important for the lesions of the neck and the throat. If we are, we have to treat the location, the lesions of the throat as well as the lesions of the neck, we have to stimulate this marma point. And it is also important to regulate the function of the Udana Vayu, and this point is also important to regulate the function of the Vyana Vayu. So Vyana Vayu can be regulated by this Tal Hirdaya Marma, and Udana Vayu is regulated by this Kshipra Marma, and the third point is over here, and it is known as the Manibandha Marma. Just you can encircle your wrist with the help of the thumb and the middle finger, and just you can move this wrist in all the directions, clockwise and anti-clockwise, and with the help of these two fingers, just you have to press very closely, and you can move this finger. And it is also important for the excitatory conditions of the brain. You are going to regulate the function of brain and you are going to calm down the brain with the help of this Manibandhu mark. The another point which is located in the hand is, this is known as the Indramasti mark. It is four finger in downward direction from this elbow joint. Just I am going to mark it over here, and this point is known as the Indravasti Marm, and this Indravasti Marm is related with the urogenital system, and this is also important to treat the diseases of the Saman Apanvayu. Apanvayu is responsible for the excretion, for the passing of the fetus, flatus, urine, and the semen and the menstrual blood. If there is any lesion present, any disease related with these organs, ultimately just we are stimulating this point, and it is very effective way to treat the diseases related with the Apanvayu. So it is very important for the disease like the benign prostatic hyperplasia, and this is there is dysuria, the diseases related with the kidneys, and chronic renal disease, and many more diseases related with the uterus, urinary bladder, and the rectum. We can treat all these diseases with the help of this Indravasti Marma. The another important Marma point is, there is Kurpar Marma, and Kurpar, there is a Sandhi, it is Sandhi Marma, just it is the total elbow joint is known as the Kurpar, but there are two very important tender points over here, sensitive points over here, both the ends. When we are putting this thumb over here and we are putting this finger in this way over this crease, the middle finger, place of the middle finger, the outer part of the Kurpar, it is very sensitive and it is very tender, it is very painful. So you can identify this Marma point with the help of this middle finger. In same way, it is the outer part or it is the lateral part, and when you are finding the medial part, it is just parallel to this lateral Marma point. Same way, just we have to put this thumb in this way, and you can find out the another sensitive point of the Kurpar Marma. These are the very sensitive point, and this point regulates the function of this middle part of the abdomen. Whenever you are putting the thumb over here, over this part, just you can find out that there is Jiffy sternum. The sternal nose to Jiffy sternum, like this. You have to put your thumb over this sternal, Jiffy sternum, and it, the little finger goes over this, over the navel part. And the, from the navel part to the Jiffy, the symphysis pubis, another 12 fingers are there. So you can see that this part consists of the lungs as well as the heart. So when we have to treat these parts, esophagus, lungs, bronchus, and heart, it can be treated by these two Marma points which are located in the upper arm. And they are known as the Ani and Urvi. This, just like the Indravasti Marm, we have to put four fingers in the upward direction, and there is the Ani, and again four finger above, there is the Urvi Marm. With the help of these two Marma points, we can regulate the function of the heart as well as the function of the lungs and the esophagus. So this point, these two points are very important to treat the functions of the pranavayu, and all these structures, lungs, heart, esophagus, can be regulated by these two points. So just we can say that this part can be treated by these two Marma points. The middle part of the abdomen from Jiffy sternum to umbilicus, it can be treated by the Kurpar Marma. And below the umbilicus up to the symphysis pubis or the lower abdomen, you can regulate these functions with the help of this Indrabasti Marg. So it is very important and very easy to treat all these diseases with the help of these Marma points. So Marma points are very important, and again just we are going to show you some specific structures. Just you can see these structures can be treated by the upper part, it can be treated by the Ani and Urvi Marg. The middle part just having a lot of organs like liver, stomach, pancreas, spleen, and the large intestine, some part of the large intestine and the stomach can be treated by the Kurpar Marg. And the lower part consists of the uterus, rectum, urinary bladder, all can be kidney, all can be treated by the Indrabasti Marg. So Indrabasti Marg is very important, and in the Indrabasti Marg organ of the thorax and abdomen, all these functions from pharynx, esophagus, stomach, and all these Marma points, all these organs can be treated by different Marma points. Ani, Urvi, Indrabasti, and the Kurpar. The whole intestinal tract, whole GIT tract, can be regulated by these organs, because the esophagus, pharynx can be treated by the Ani, Urvi, the stomach can be treated by the Kurpar, the pancreas, all these things can be treated by the Kurpar Marg, and the remaining part of the small intestine, large intestine, anus can be treated by the Indrabasti Marg. So just we can treat the all organs of the thorax and the abdomen with the help of these Marg points located in the upper extremity. In same way, the urinary system and the endocrine system, it also gives the good response with the help of this in the urinary system, the kidney, renal pelvis, ureter, urinary bladder, and the urethra. In all these conditions, three or four Marma points are very important. Number one, the Indrabasti. Second one is the Vasti Marg. And the third one is the Vitap Marg. Fourth one is the Parshasandhi Marg. And fifth one is the Gulf Sandhi. So all Gulf Marma and remaining Marma are very much effective in all urinary problems. In case of, just you can see again, there is repetition, the chest lung bronchitis like problem, chest lung bronchitis like problems can be treated by Ani and Urvi Marg. The diabetes, liver, spleen, stomach problems can be treated by Kurpar Marg, and all urinary related disorders, prostate for the men, UTI for the female patients, they can be treated by the Indrabasti Marg. For all heart and the brain related issues can be solved by the Tal Hriday Marg. Now the Marma points of the upper extremity, how we are going to identify the Marma points of upper extremity? Just I have shown you the Marma point of upper extremity. First of all, there is Tal Hriday Marg. You can see how we are going to divide the whole palm into two parts, and one longitudinal line which we are drawing through the middle finger, and just we are dividing the palm into two parts, a imaginary line. The junction of these two lines is known as the Tal Hriday Marg. Indrabasti Marg is four finger downward from the elbow joint, and Kshipra Marg is located between these two fingers, thumb and the index finger. So Manibandh, Kshipra Marg, Tal Hriday, Indrabasti, Kurpar, Ani and Urvi are important Marma points of upper extremity. Now you have to learn the techniques of the self Marma therapy of upper extremity. Just I have told you earlier that there are three types of Marma therapy. First of all, self Marma therapy means by which one can treat his or her Marma points by himself or herself. Apne ke se kaise dabaye, it is very important. It is very important, and there is some difference between the self marma therapy and the therapeutic marma therapy, because the therapeutic marma therapy is given by a doctor to the patient. In this condition, there is some modifications are there, but for the self marma therapy, you have to consider how we are giving the marma therapy to ourselves to keep ourselves fit or just for the recovery from some diseases. The respiratory and the circulatory systems are closely interrelated, and just you can see whenever there is heart is affected, so there will may be some changes in the heart, in the lungs, and when the lungs are affected, there may be some changes in the heart. So these marma points are closely related, and the Ani and Urvi marma are very important in both the systems. And even in these conditions, the Talhrida marma of all four extremities, sole and palm, and the Ani Urvi marma and the Hrida marma are very important. And there are two marma points are very important for respiratory system, which are known as the Stanmool and the Stanrohit, which are located over the chest, and they are just two finger below and the two finger above then the nipple. So these marma points are very important for the respiratory and the circulatory system. The stimulation of the marma travels through the nerve. Just we can say that all marma points are working through this nervous stimulation. It is the just you can say that it is the multifold calculated stimulus from peripheral nervous system to the central nervous system. Now the identification of the marma points of the local lower extremity. In same way as in the upper extremity, the distribution of marma point in lower extremity is little bit same, but some nomenclatures are different. Talhrida marma is same. It is also located on the sole. And the second one is the Kshipra marma, which is known in upper extremity. It is known as the Manibandha marma. In this lower extremity, it is known as the Gulf marma. Kshipra marma is same. Kshipra marma is also known in the upper extremity. It is also between the first big toe and the second toe. And it is in the upper extremity. It is the junction of the thumb and the index finger. So Kshipra marma is the same term used in the upper extremity and the lower extremity. But in Indravasti, it is also same. It is located in the upper extremity and the lower extremity. But the Kurpar marma is known as Janu Sandhi, Janu marma in the lower extremity. Ani Urvi is same in as in upper extremity and the lower extremity. The marma therapy for the lower extremity, how we are giving the marma therapy, just you can see, just we are giving the pressure to the Urvi marma, Ani marma, Janu marma, Indravasti marma, and just Gulf marma, just we are going to stimulate by different technique. In all other marma points, just you are giving pressure with the help of thumb, but in case of the Gulf marma, just you are stimulating with the help of the knuckle. And you have not to give the pressure, you have to vibrate this marma, because it is very sensitive, it is very painful, and it is very important marma point of the lower extremity. In most of the diseases, symptomatic treatment is available, and the lifelong term or the long term management is needed, and there is net gain in terms of the treatment is very low. Even for the coryza, allergic manifestation, high blood pressure, coronary artery disease, diabetes, hyperacidity, arthritis, there is no proper treatment available in the modern medical science. We know that in a coryza or any allergic manifestation, we have to take some anti-allergic medicine or some steroid for a longer period. And in especially in case of high blood pressure, you have to take the medicine lifelong, and it is same in the case of the diabetes. We have to take the medicine lifelong, and there is no permanent treatment of all these diseases available in the modern medical science. There is a gap of thousands of years in the teaching, training, and learning of the Vedic medical science due to many unavoidable circumstances. In the present situation, where the whole medical science is away from the reach of the common man, due to its expensiveness and hazards. Side effects are also there. ADR is also there. It was decided to take the privilege to making the format of this Marma Science and Marma Therapy. The entire process of the self Marma Therapy and the specific Marma Therapy for the ailments should be known to all, because every person has to write off their of health, gaining the health. So with the help of the yoga, with the help of this Marma Therapy, everyone can get his health in a very proper way. So the knowledge of important anatomical structures in relation to the Marma points is mandatory, and it is a critical ingredient in Marma practice and the therapy. Important anatomical structures and landmarks and their interrelationship is also important to know, as they inform certain Marma therapy processes. Because when we are not knowing the actual location, actual constituent part of the Marma, so in that condition, that situation, we cannot give the proper Marma stimulation to the proper Marma point. Being an untouched method of healing, more and more working hands are needed to spread the knowledge and benefit of this science. The teaching, training, and the confidence building is the science in the science is the need of the hour. So the learning of the Marma science and the Marma process, Marma therapy, and just we have to follow the procedure. Learning of the Marma science can be performed under the following steps. Number first, we have to know the theoretical knowledge. It is known as study of the subject. Second one is the mastery in the subject is very necessary. And the third one is the visual practical experience, and the experimental study is very necessary. And fifth one is the internship. And sixth one is the independent practice is there, should be there. So teaching and the training of the Marma science is very necessary. You have to know the actual location of the Marma point. If you are not knowing the actual location of Marma point, you cannot stimulate the actual Marma point, and you cannot give the proper results in terms of the cure. So the learning of these techniques, it is very important. So in teaching and the practical demonstration, it is very necessary. You have to learn these Marma points under the guidance of a very experienced teacher. Because Marma science is very important, and it is very dangerous if it is not done properly. So it gives very hazards. There are many hazards when it is not treated properly. So we can understand the importance of these Marma points, and by the help of these Marma stimulation of Marma point, we can cure a lot of diseases.